Hi, I'm Jeff Chubb with the REN Network, and today we're here with Jason Bonarigo of RMS Mortgage, and we're talking about the pre-commitment. Now, there's a difference between pre-qualification, pre-approval, and then this pre-commitment. That's what we really want to dive in today. Ultimately, why should I get a pre-commitment? Who was it for? So let's tell me what is a pre-commitment?
Well, first off, it's just a little bit more extensive than your normal pre-approval.
Okay.
Which is obviously just kind of not a quick certification, but we can do that pretty quickly, right?
Right.
We do that in, 10 minutes sometimes or 24 hours.
Right. And you're doing that. It's just you.
It's just me. Right. Yeah. No, exactly. Great point. So the difference between obviously the pre-approval and the pre-commitment is we're actually taking the time and we're sending it into the underwriting department to truly have it underwritten and stamped.
Right.
There's no going back season.
Where they comb through the financials.
Financials, right, and that may sound overwhelming, but it's really not. I mean, it's the same essential information that you've already given me on the pre-approval. I may ask for a couple more things, just some basic stuff, pay stubs, W-2s, bank statements, all the things that you need to do anyways. And then we have that, we take that, we package it up nice as we would, make it beautiful, and we submit it into underwriting. So
right.
Again, when it comes out, it's clean. We know if there's any issues that we have to question at all. We feel good about that. And then basically, you're subject to finding a home, which is your job, and then B, getting that appraisal, which would be the only thing that we would discuss going forward. Hey, making sure the value's there.
Right.
Like it's really,
so
really cool.
So essentially, right? I reached out to you because we've had buyers that put in 2, 3, 4 offers. And I think somebody who's put in one or two offers,
yep.
Right, then maybe it's time for them to move towards this pre-commitment phase where it ultimately makes them a little bit more competitive in that home buying.
It can make it a lot more competitive,
right?
I mean, I think that's why we talked about that option, and that's why obviously good lenders are offering that service. It's so competitive. We've seen that people losing out on homes, and I don't understand. I have good credit.
Right.
I'm making these offers, and everything looks good, and I'm just not getting them. Well, sellers, they have an abundance to choose from, and maybe it's down payment, maybe it's a quick close. And again, that leads to the other point is we can do maybe a much faster closing now because we're halfway through the process, right?
Right.
It's already been underwritten. It's already been approved. All we need is the appraisal. So
right.
If you call me and normally if you say, Jay, can you do a 20-day closing? I'd say no, but obviously if that's what we need and these buyers have been out there for months and months and they can't get, find the house that they want, then yeah, we have that option. We have a lot more flexibility. And again, you do a great job of letting those sellers know that, look, these guys are pre-committed.
Right.
With one of our top local lenders, this is how they feel. They're certified, they're ready to go. And it makes them a lot more competitive.
So we have cash offers. Cash is king, right?
Yes.
And then
it's
you
not
have.
Good for me, though.
It's not good for you. It can be great for me.
Exactly.
Sense, right?
I like that.
But we have cash offers.
Yes. Sellers like cash offers.
Yes, sellers love them, right? And it's hard to compete with a cash
it
offer.
Is.
And we're seeing
it
a
is.
Ton of cash
sure,
offers in
sure.
this market.
But that's a good point.
This
ties the knot.
This pre-commitment gets us a little bit closer to
sure.
that cash offer where myself as a, as an agent, I can say to the seller's agent, the person representing the seller, say, hey, look, I understand this isn't a cash offer, but this is as close as it's going to get. These guys have already been through underwriting. I mean, from them, from their standpoint, they're rock solid.
It's done.
All we
right.
need to worry about
it's
is the house
fun.
Appraising.
And that's
right?
Jeff, that's a great point because I think you and I know, we won't mention any names, but we had one a couple weeks ago where they took the lower bid,
right?
And it was a cash offer,
yeah.
And they did go with our buyer who was obviously pre-approved. Now, they weren't pre-committed,
right.
But they were pre-approved, but again, very strong and good buyers, but the seller took less money.
Less money.
For had that peace of mind for the cash. Now, we can debate whether that was the right decision, but Jeff's point is correct, is if you're pre-committed, you're essentially right there with cash, right? And a good down payment.
Just the appraisal,
done.
Which there can still, appraisals can come in still low. So there is a little risk there for the sellers. But, if you're $10,000 above the next offer.
Or even more.
Right.
In our case, I think it was even more. So, I mean, that's just a huge benefit. And, you need it in this market, again, when you're seeing 10, 12 multiple bids on these good homes that are for sale. So.
Right. Yeah, things are moving quick. So the pre-commitment. Right,
yeah.
So we've gotten the pre-commitment. I mean, does it look any different? So it sounds like it's really up to me in order to really sell and educate the other side in regards to the difference between that pre-commitment and the
once you have it.
Correct?
Right, we'll make it obviously look a little bit different for the
right.
consumer so it stands out and basically says that. And we take any of the boilerplate stuff off our normal pre-approval so it looks a little bit cleaner and gives them more confidence.
Right.
And then, of course, you would verbally explain to your partner there or the listening agent, what it entails. And then they're going to understand. understand it too, because again, we like to think we run in the same circles.
And then they can call you too,
of course. I mean, which we get calls all the time, and I actually prefer that.
Right.
You know, some I talk to some people, oh, I'm getting calls from listing agents. I think it's great. It helps my buyers out. I like to think I sound okay on the phone, and I make them feel comfortable that no, I just it just wasn't a quick pre-qual.
You got a great phone voice. Face not so much for video.
Yeah, exactly. Right. When they say a face for radio.
Yeah.
But I, you know, I talk to the listing agents and they feel good about it and they just ask the basic questions, but they get the sense that A, we know what we're doing, that the buyer's in good hands, and B, they know I've collected all the proper documentation.
Right.
You know?
All right, so pre-commitment, what does it get me? It gets me the ability to close a loan faster.
True.
Peace of mind that I'm fully approved on that side of it,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
All I have to do is an appraisal, yeah, right? Makes me more competitive,
I have
a lot higher chance of actually securing the house.
Yeah.
Anything else?
No,
I'm missing anything?
Not really.
No.
I mean, that just that, again.
They're pretty big things.
Those are three pretty big things. And again, I don't want to stress anyone out. It's not that painful. It's essentially the same documentation as we would with a pre-approval.
Just
it just takes a little bit more time, but we have that dialogue and we know, hey, while you're still looking for homes, we're going to get you on the pre-commitment track so that we can get that done, send it into underwriting, and when it comes out, we're good to go.
But you're going to need to give the docs anyway.
Anyway.
So you might as well just do it again in the beginning time before everything gets really crazy and you've gone under agreement, you need to do the home inspection and start packing your house to get ready to move and all that
and
stuff, right?
And I'm asking you for 100 documentation. So, you'd rather have that done, to be honest with you. Yeah.
So, okay. Well, great. Thanks so very much for clearing that up and you know, working with our clients in order to make them more competitive for this pre-commitment. Again, I'm Jeff Chubb with the Chubb Realty Group. We're brokered by eXp Realty. And this is Jason Bonarigo of RMS Mortgage. Jason, how can they reach you?
Cell phone's always the best. Shoot me a text. Give me a call. 617-413-5038.
You can always reach us at 617-480-2600 or visit us online at www.boston2.com. Thanks for watching. We look forward to hearing from you and talk to you soon.